I have started a new recording. Yoink.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on with this article.
Poof!
The four beacons have been active for a while now.
Maybe it is active for somebody else? But I can't see the arc sign over there towards pretty much north. To the north.
Yeah, I don't think that's anything to do with it.
Okay, and there is some sort of minor skirmish site here. I bet if I get any closer, then goons will come out. I will check this out. Ahem. Huh, no goons? Oh, maybe it's storyline related?
Hmm. Not quite sure what's up with this thing.
Have you tried turning it off and on again?
Yes, and it won't turn off.
So somebody has activated these, but nothing is happening.
Yeah, it would seem so. Although everyone's just standing around waiting, so this might be normal.
Maybe there is a random element to this.
I'm just gonna message Arcfall with impact window nearby.
Mm-hmm.
Did you get that just now?
No.
Okay. Maybe I just like went outside the area and back in or something.
Could be, because when I was wandering about, then I got some sort of message that an Arcfall is nearby, something.
Yeah. There is a major Arcfall on like the other island down below. Maybe they're going to be one at a time on the server?
Could be.
So maybe it's like waiting for that one to finish before it
triggers
this one.
Ah, okay. Yeah.
I'm guessing. Just
that sounds... Yeah, that sounds kind of make sense-y. Dark Matter Mayhem is the other one that I'm seeing. I think I actually participated on that one before. Ah, gear change. All the grenades are just blinking in the air like poof, 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 poof.
Yeah, I don't know what causes that.
I guess if the enemy despawns before you're able to detonate it.
I think they detonate automatically when the enemy dies.
Oh, I don't know then. Another one of those alternate reality things. Like in the Schrödinger's universe, the grenades never went off.
Mm. Remember reading a thing about was it infinite universe theory.
Mm-hmm.
Like for every action, there's a like both outcomes actually happen.
Mm-hmm.
Sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And there's one if you repeatedly try to shoot yourself in the head, you live forever. Because the gun never goes off.
Ah, oh, yeah, that's the proof of the multiverse.
Yeah. I'm gonna buy a gun and try that out. I'll try it on somebody else instead.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember a while back IO9 had something on it too. Or the same theorizing thing. Nothing is happening! Like, I move backwards, then she will hold the cannon up like this. And I move forward, she holds it normally, and then poof!
Yeah, my guy does that too. When he's backpedaling, he holds the gun ready to fire.
Yeah, almost like...
Place forwardy.
Ah, it's like when you're backing up, then it's as if you're shooting over a cover, maybe. I don't know. But with the rifle...
Firing while retreating, I would guess. Versus running toward a target.
Yep. Like when you're running forward, then they hold it as they hold them on the move, or on the march. But when you're backing up, then it's in shooting position. Okay, that makes sense. Because why else would you backpedal if you weren't shooting at something at the same time? I get the logic.
Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna quickly stop recording. Start recording.
Okay.
Just to get rid of some of the dead space in the file.
Yep.
I don't know if this is actually going to go up anywhere, but this is new and interesting, so I'm recording it just in case.
Yep. I did this with my Wasteland 2.
75 XP.
Yeah. With my Wasteland 2 playthrough. And there are some encounters that are a little bit too difficult or a little bit too tough for me, so I'm repeating them like a million times before I get through. And I would keep recording, and in the end I would scrap most of the recordings, but I would still keep recording each time just in case I succeed this time.
Kind of like Stargate. The guy keeps saying, "We're all going to die," and they don't die.
Yeah.
I thought you said we're all going to die. What? I missed my last chance to be right.
That sounds like O'Neill would say it.
It was O'Neill and what do you call Sam's dad? Selmac.
Selmac is the symbiote, but father's name is Jacob, I think. The human counterpart is Jacob, and Selmac is the symbiote.
Yeah, I think that's it. Well, Selmac kept saying we're all going to die.
Ah.
Jack was being very sort of sassy about it. Excuse me. Excuse me. I thought you said we're all going to die. What? Missed my last ever chance to be right? I miss that series.
Yep. And this universe was just getting interesting.
Yeah, never seen it.
It's darker than the others, and and it's got some of its elements are stretching the believability a little bit too much, I think. But I think it was in one of the latter seasons. Where they had this idea that they had found an ancient database with a ninth coordinate or a ninth chevron, or an address with nine chevrons, and they never had enough. They couldn't generate enough power to check it out, and they managed to work it out and dialed at the address, and as they were doing this, the site where they were dialing from came under attack, and some of the people were evacuated, but others went through the gate, and they end up on a ship that's on automated mission across everywhere, and that's the setting. But I think the cast was a little bit uneven. Like they had Robert Carlyle, which meant that some of the cast that would have seemed competent in a more evenly spread company now seemed a little bit too like okay. maybe get another actor. Yeah.
Who's Robert Carlyle?
Hmm?
Who is Robert Carlyle?
We all are.
I'm terrible with like actor names and stuff. Like you show me the face, like, oh yeah, I know him. But
let me see. You seen Full Monty?
No.
Let's try more recent. Once Upon a Time?
No.
Ravenous?
No.
Let me think. He's been in many things. Like he's very prolific, I think.
I've heard the name before, but I don't
yeah.
know it. Like I hear the name, but I don't associate it with anything.
Should be Scottish, like a wiry short guy, very animated features, sort of fiery eyes. Hair color, varies, white guy.
I'm just gonna look him up.
Yeah. Very good actor too. That's why I said that the cast was a little bit unevenly spread. Like.
All I can see is blackness in his eyes. He's evil.
Yeah. He's played some very good evil characters. I mean, great
yeah,
evil
he
characters.
He looked a bit like that guy from what do you call it? The car show.
Weasel. I know hamster. Yeah. I know who you mean.
Jeremy Clarkson. Top Gear.
Richard.
Hammond.
Yep.
I'm looking at his thing on IMDb. I don't think I've seen any of these films.
Okay. I definitely recommend Ravenous.
Castlevania? Oh, a video game. Yeah, that makes more sense. Like, yeah, I played that in the SNES. Yeah, I haven't seen any of his films at all.
Huh. Okay. Fair enough.
No, never mind. I've seen The World Is Not Enough.
Hmm.
Yeah, I've seen him in that. That's where I recognize him from.
Oh, okay.
He was like the bad guy with a bullet in his brain. Like, this way. Dying's gonna kill him eventually. He lost like all feeling and stuff. Like, he could shoot him and he would know he'd been shot, but it wouldn't hurt.
Oh, okay.
Because, like, it was slowly, like, disabling parts of his nervous system or something as well.
Hmm. Shit shutting down little by
yeah.
little.
That was sort of a major plot point that he was dead anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So he was a little bit sort of fearless. I think he actually like, picked up lumps of hot coal and stuff to burn people with when he was displeased.
Displaced.
Me for the last time. Hold this. Cycle of recording again. That other arc fall is done, I think. Unless that's mood, that's like the final.
Oh.
Yeah, that'd be it. Because before it had the strike,
yeah,
the little circle around the strike, and then the bigger circle showing the area. But in the final ones, the big circle I think collapses to the size of the small one.
Okay.
But it's the final thing. So I'll just sit here listening to rustling. And virtually glare at whoever's doing it. I know they can hear us, like. They're just a jerk, aren't they? They think so. Ah, explosions. Herbigurd! Herbigurd, I'm exploding.
Yeah, I figured out that I should probably change from...
Oh, which part of the defense?
Oh! That I should probably... Change back to a grenade launcher, because that would give me a little bit more control and less chance to blow myself up all the time. Because
you
with
think
the
so, but no.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I take it you have tested this already.
Yes.
Aha. Uh-huh. On the same premise?
No, I just have a grenade launcher.
Okay.
Very nice grenade launcher, actually. I can't remember where I got it, but it's like an orange one.
Mm-hmm.
With the Eternal Presence thing, it gives like lots of ammo and stuff.
Okay.
Bigger magazines and all that. I fully modded it and upgraded it and stuff. It's very nice. But it runs out of ammo very quick.
Ah.
It holds 14 grenades. The thing is, they kind of explode on impact, not the sticky ones.
Ah, okay. Yeah,
so
yeah,
I
yeah.
turn around and shoot something, it just explodes in my face.
Yep. So yeah, I meant specifically the sticky one, because then I would have the actual control over the detonation. Because right now, when I'm running about...
I have one you can maybe have when you level up a bit.
Oh, maybe.
It's a 994.
Cluster bomb. Yeah, because with
it's
this
purple.
One...
It's a 5-round magazine.
Uh-huh.
Fires manually detonate a grenade, send it a cluster of explosives.
Okay.
So it's basically the grenade version of what you've got now.
Whee! Time to go. Right now I've got mass cannon. The other one
yeah.
that I had was cluster cannon. Oh, they're leaving! Don't leave!
Yeah, this is it here. Manually detonated. Small cluster of grenades.
Whoa!
Nice.
This is pretty good idea, actually. Shoot up there, and...
You can fire multiple shots before reloading.
Hmm?
You can fire multiple shots.
Yep. And when I think when it's closer to the ground. Ah, yeah, these smaller bits explode on impact, so they don't explode when coming down from the sky until they've reached the ground. I might have killed us. Ah, okay, this was the last bit. Okay. Going for ammo.
I need ammo too. I fired a grenade.
Yep.
I'm one round short of like full reserve.
Unacceptable.
And my OCD is kind of fucking me about.
Yeah. So...
I'm one round short of a magazine.
Where's the event?
Follow the blinky lights.
Whee!
I don't know if Nux wants in on this.
No, I'm alright. I'm rendering.
Arcfall redirect site detected.
Arcfall redirect site? This is new.
Yeah. Well, you know the arcfall we called down?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
That was a minor arcfall site. This is a major arcfall site with like 4 redirect beacons.
You are recording it though, aren't you?
Yes.
And nothing is happening.
I don't know if you were listening earlier or not, but I've upped my bitrate to 20 megabits instead of 10. And it seems to be much better, especially with like fast movement and stuff. It is significantly better.
Nice.
Better quality just overall. Especially if you're going to be like re-encoding it as part of your editing process.
Alright, nice.
It does mean twice the file size though. But I think it's a worthwhile trade-off.
Mm-hmm.
Especially if it's going to be like raw material for rendering.
Yeah. There is a sample up on my Google Drive folder, the ChaosNova one.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to have a look at it.
We have bad guys. Up the hill.
They're not bad guys, they're sort of irritating guys. Oh my god, why is this not coming down? Going on like it was that weird, like, alternate reality thing, it's actually all over.
Yep.
What are the chances of it, like, coming down right now? I might travel to the fork and back down just to see if it's coming up in reality thing.
Okay, I will keep shooting these guys here. Meanwhile.
Lots of lag.
Just stay down.
Yeah, the server's extremely laggy right now for some reason.
Yep. Picking up stuff and getting the results in from shooting anything are laggy and there's the moonwalking NPCs thing, and
I wonder, is the server been gearing up for this major thing?
Maybe?
Like sort of reassigning and preloading resources and things like that.
I have an unrelated stupid question. Every now and again I see a green text popping up saying contender. Do you know what that means?
You're right. That is a stupid question.
Well?
No, it's to do with your shield or your perks or whatever. Anytime the perk ability or shield ability activates,
okay.
You get a little like message like that.
Yeah, because there was a shield animation.
Anytime you get a little thing popping up saying yada,
yeah,
means you just got extra loot.
Mm-hmm.
I have two mobile items. What can I claim? Customization reason. Furious typing.
Advancing.
What?
Yes. What's wrong?
I was poking at this and something said advancing. Oh, there's like an invisible guy in this. In this house.
Oh yeah, slimer.
grenades. Yoink. So my hearing was alright.
Yes, you're hearing voices. Not that they're in your head, I'm just saying that there's voices and you're hearing them.
Yep. Oh, there is another event in another direction now. Oh yeah, ammo.
Wait, why am I getting ammo? I didn't shoot anything.
Reflexes?
Yes. Yeah. Yes, Ego, I know it's been detected.
Potential arcfall site detected.
Emphasis on potential.
Well, I'm just gonna wait here for it. What's that thing in the sky? Thud. Hermagerd cars.
I think it's nearing, because if people are starting to come by. Also, something says total score. Total score of what?
Mm-hmm. Only seems to pop up when you get near that, though.
Ah, yeah. Yep. Total score.
The spear's here.
Uh-huh. Interesting.
I think it's just the proximity thing. A vault swarm at the bathhouse. Diablo vaccine synthesizer. Excuse me. There's actually a lot of different events going on. I'm wondering maybe if, rather than like a single major arc fall, it's just some kind of overall limit on events. Like the server has X amount of resources, you know.
Yeah.
Like that, was it Fortress Craft of Old game? There've been a few YouTubers doing it lately. It's like Factorio meets Minecraft.
I don't know it.
Well, the way it loads the level, the chunks of the level in, is based on frame rate. The higher your frame rate, the more it loads in. Kind of clever. So it maintains sort of a consistent level of performance, and better computer just lets you load more in.
Okay. This person is back. Oh, somebody else is coming as well.
This is marked on the map, you know. So yep. Might just be people coming to invest again.
Yeah, check up, check out what's the haps. Who said it? What's the haps? I think it's, was it in New Vegas, the jukebox?
The one in Old World Blues?
Yeah. What was it? Blind Diode?
Blind Diode Jefferson, yeah.
What's the haps?
People watching this video are going to get very, very dizzy.
I've got this.
You know, there's probably a point in that recording where you could just like cut it and loop it. Whatever. Like, as long as you were standing still. Loop. Yeah, loopable. buggy, and I am slowly drifting off my target here because of this little sort of bump.
Ah, yeah, the terrain is not even.
Hmm. Of course, you know the first thing that we're going to notice about this, like, being activated, is it landing on our heads.
Wait, what?
When this thing finally does activate, the first we'll know about it is when it lands on our heads.
Yep.
La 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 la, thump.
La 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 la. Proper La La Land.
Look at the meat arrow bit. Not actually watching that or not. He heard his name being mentioned, he stopped typing.
I'm talking to KO about Shadowrun.
Huh.
Bye. Bye. We know what kind of website you're on.
I didn't realize there was a Mech Warrior tabletop game.
No, we're not playing.
We're not playing it right this very second.
If you wish, you could integrate it into Shadowrun.
This is mechanics research, not like game. And besides, Shadowrun's already got a mechanic for mech type vehicles using the anthropomorphic doodads.
Yeah, but who says you can't do a bit of crossover? Giant, fuck off, mech machine with chain guns, rocket launchers, flamethrowers, and everything. So on. Like, you turn out to meet Mr. Johnson and, like, 50 foot high robot. Hey, how you doing?
There's a good chance that we'll be able to get. It's like Battletech, and it's all figures and stuff like that. It probably isn't applicable to what we're trying to research here. But we could definitely play it out in like Tabletop Simulator or whatever, because you can download like the figurines or whatever.
And how much do they cost?
Probably nothing. I think it's user created content.
No.
Like, it's not licensed or anything, but it is like as good as, like, you can get the Battlestar Galactica.
Oh yeah. Okay, I actually managed to make myself a little bit dizzy. Blark.
I can just kind of see you like over the handlebars throwing up.
Yeah, that way.
Oh god, throwing up into the wind.
Delicious.
Like you're doing 30 or 40 kilometers an hour, looking forward, you just throw up. It immediately comes back in your face.
Blah.
Yeah,
throwing up in a roller coaster.
I was very diligently trying to manage my trajectory, and then I realized that I was actually kind of getting nauseous. It was like there was a camping event one time, and me and a bunch of other girls, we chose to ride back of a truck. Like it was this I don't know what you call them, where you have the sort of dark storage compartment in the back. Like you have maybe
flatbed
two,
truck.
Maybe not flatbed. You have like a space.
Boot or trunk?
No, it wasn't. It wasn't trunk. It was it was like proper Benny space. Hub. Yeah, kind of. Anyway, we chose to ride in the back with the gear, and I think it was about 14 minutes ride. or maybe an hour or so. And the first 20 minutes, everybody was very talkative. We were chatting non-stop. And then at about 30 minutes, I noticed everybody's getting kind of
Arcfall impact window nearby.
Kind of quiet, and like I felt like, oh gosh, the motion sickness was sinking in. It's because it wasn't the freshest air there, like not like swimming in gasoline or anything, but still you could smell the car fumes a little bit, and it had that space had no windows or anything, so we weren't specifically paying mind in you know, staying alert or staying focused. We were just sort of relaxing and babbling, basically.
Yeah, I've noticed that. Like, if you're getting seasick, look at the horizon.
Yep.
It sort of helps restore your like inner balance.
Yep.
But with no windows, you can't do that.
Yep, exactly.
Yeah, I think you actually become motion sick because it's like a disconnect between like what you're seeing and
input and
what you're feeling.
Disconnect between input and balance.
Yeah, conflict.
Yep. Does not compute.
This is how you do it.
I ran into some bugs.
Go kill them.
Oh, there's an NPC here. Oopsie. Grenades! Yes.
My work here is done.
And of course the NPCs speak no further.
Thanks for the help, I piss off.
Yeah. Don't leave me here! Okay, thanks, bye!
This is kind of annoying.
Yep. Shall we get more proactive and seek out an active event?
I don't know. I really want to see what this one does, but it doesn't look like it's going to do anything at this rate. I just don't know.
I bet that the minute we leave this site and get somewhere else and get active somewhere else, this shit kicks in.
Yeah. Can't interact with these in any way, it doesn't seem to be.
Mm-hmm.
Anything I can do to trigger things.
I'm trying to punch it.
Hitting it doesn't help.
Yep.
I'm just down here and go AFK.
Shooting doesn't do anything either.
Somebody fire!
Yeah. site? What's happening there? Solstice strike. It's southeast. Is that visible from here? I will peek over yonder. Let's see what's happening down there.
Major arcfall site is a major bulge arcfall. Four arc spikes are deployed, which call in a large piece of one of the arcs, attracting the attention of mutants, raiders, or dark matter. Bulge emerge from the arc when defeated, allow access. Inside the arc piece where a bulge war master is located. I'm guessing that's something huge. Yes, that is huge.
Huge. Big ass. So the thing that's happening in
history. The War Master is used to break sieges against enemies serving on the front lines. Concept art. Okay, yeah, you know the normal, like, bulge troopers?
Uh-huh.
This thing is about 5 times taller than those.
Did they show up already?
No. I'm looking at the concept art.
Oh, okay.
But there's one of those like normal troopers here, but I think for scale. So yeah, this guy is like 3 or 4 stories tall.
Okay. Okay, I have been messing around with my vehicle now. And I think I lost the event. Oh no! I actually reached the right place, but the event has ended. So, I wonder... Of course there was a road. Of course there was. Starren Pond. Nice name, I suppose.
I don't know what that means. Well, that bathhouse event is about to finish.
I'm on my way! I think...
I'm up on the hill.
Far away.
Whee!
You get a good jump going up here, I think, if you can get the speed up.
Like this?
No, where I was sitting.
Huh. Get me up there! Just a second, what was that? Stop shooting at me. I'm driving here.
That's me.
can't get up here. Damn. Stop shooting, stupid mutants.
Don't make me hurt you.
Still nothing happening. What did you do?
I made it across the
channel. One position corrected, this little buggy becomes pretty much like a jetpack.
Or sunset stuff. Interesting. I accidentally all opened this.
You did what?
I find a neat place over there.
Oh, nice.
Totally by accident.
Yep.
I was thinking about it deep. Large number of eyes has kind of been obvious.
I like how these things just sort of refuel on their own.
Maybe they're solar powered.
But it is night time! But they have some sort of like a little reactor thingy on the back, so maybe that's the fuel hand wave. Major arcful site.
I'm gonna squeak you, Leo.
Okay, I'm gonna pause the recording so that... so that I will have, like, a breakpoint. Whee! In case something starts happening, like, right away.